What's poppin' YouTube? It's your boy Sabby. Thank you so much for tuning in to another episode. Welcome to my channel, Self Mastery. Today's topic is how to attract a healthy relationship. I will be bringing in some concepts from the law of attraction, manifestation practices, guys. Stay tuned. There's a lot of good information in this video, especially if you have been on this journey to attract that healthy mate, that healthy partner. Guys, I will tell you in this video how it's done, because I too am in a healthy relationship right now, and I have been for almost 3 years. Guys, this is the video for you, so let's get started. First thing I want to say, follow my IG, hit the like button if you haven't already, and subscribe to my channel, guys. It means a lot for the support and love that you guys have shown me. Let's get to 1,000 subscribers. Thank you once again. But let's talk about it. First thing I want to say, if you want to attract a healthy partner, I would say write down a list of characteristics that you want your partner to have. Now, you know, this could be physical attributes, how they look, how tall they are, you know, maybe hair color, eye color, whatever your preferences are, guys. You know, everybody has different preferences. Write them down on a list. Right, then write down, you know, some emotional attributes. How do you want them to be emotionally? Are they emotionally healthy? Right, are they joyous? Are they happy? Are they in tune? Are they, you know, always in a good mood? They're easy, they're calm, they're cool, they're collected. You know, how do you want them to be, guys? The emotional attributes. Then list out some of their mental, you know, faculties, their mental attributes that, you know, appease you. This could be, you know, they're psychologically healthy, but they've healed their trauma, if any, right? Or, you know, they're very smart, or they're intelligent, they're, you know, readers, they're intellectual, they're good conversationalists, whatever, guys, the list goes on, you're right? Then maybe you can write some of their spiritual aspects. You know, they're close to God, they pray, they meditate, you know, they practice gratitude, they like yoga, they like, you know, they're into law of attraction like you, whatever, guys, whatever it is, you know, write all these characteristics out. Maybe some hobbies, maybe some, you know, other things that you may desire in a partner. Take that list, guys, and have that list, obviously, but pick your top 10 from there. Top 10 things that you cannot compromise on, right? Could be maybe, you know, they're loyal. That, I mean, that for me is a big one. Like, I cannot compromise on loyalty. If I'm in a healthy relationship, my partner has to be loyal, or else I'm not in that relationship. So maybe that's one thing for you. Maybe, you know, you can write their, like, it's healthy communication. Because a lot of people, right, they get confrontational, or they don't communicate, or they get quiet. For me, I like healthy communication. If you have a problem, if something's bothering you, you know, we can discuss it in a healthy way. That's an important quality for me, obviously. And then also, you know, their ability to, you know, get along with you, the ease of flowing with you, right? Maybe you're looking for a spiritual resonance. Maybe that's an important quality to you. Write that out, guys. Write down your top 10 things that you cannot compromise on. And then look at that list every single day, guys. Look at that list every day. Read it every day. The reason I say this is because it's going to fixate in your subconscious mind the qualities that you desire in a partner. So every time you go out on a date, every time you go out and, you know, you see people or you meet people, these qualities are active in your mind, right? They're ingrained, imprinted in your subconscious. So this is what you look for. This is exactly what you're looking for. And so, you know, if someone doesn't meet that, maybe if someone, you know, is too promiscuous for your requirements, right? Then you realize, hey man, like, it's not gonna work with this person. It's not the kind of person I want to be with. I'm looking for more of like a good girl or a good guy, you know, not looking for like a person that's still in their hoe phase, so to speak, guys. So you know what I mean. But you want to know exactly what it is that you want. A lot of people don't even know what they want, and so that's why the universe sends them, you know, mixed people all the time, is because they don't have a list compiled, guys. Many years ago, many years ago, I compiled a list, you know, and I would read it often. But guys, it really helped me hone in on what I wanted in a partner. And I'm living that right now. I did attract that. So this is, you know, a success story if you want to look at it. You know, I'll talk about it maybe in another video sometime. But remember that, guys, you want to have a list of the qualities that you want. Let's get into the next thing that I want to say, is that also look at your list and see where in those qualities that you want, you are lacking. So let me say this in other words, right? If you want someone that's respectful, are you respectful? Right? Look at yourself as well, because you have to meet the requirements of your requirements, guys. That's how law of attraction works, right? You're not going to attract someone that's not like you or not where you are. So if you're disrespectful, you're not going to attract a respectful partner because you yourself are disrespectful. If you have anger, if you're angry all the time, how can you attract a cool and calm and loving partner, guys? It's not going to work like that. You're going to attract more of the same. So look at that list and then see for yourself, right? Where are some requirements that you want? Maybe you want a partner that's really fit, has a fit body, but you're overweight. Guys, it's not going to work like that, right? So you got to figure out where it is that you need to improve, where you need to grow, and take the time, the necessary time while you're single, to work on those qualities, guys. Build those qualities within yourself, whatever those qualities are. A big one for me, right, is if you don't want a cheater, are you a cheater, right? Are you someone that is promiscuous? Are you someone that, you know, cannot be trusted? Look at yourself as well, guys, because the thing is, we want our partner to be perfect, but then when it comes to, you know, looking at ourselves, we sort of let it go by, right? We sweep it under the rug when it comes to looking at ourselves. So don't do that, guys. You have to work on yourself to do the self-work. Because if you want someone that's also, you know, spiritually in alignment, you must be spiritually in alignment as well. So that, you know, that goes without saying. Next thing I want to say, guys, is take the time when you're alone to practice self-love. That's very important, because I've noticed one thing about relationships is people jump in too quick. People jump in too quick because they don't have this confidence, this contentment, this fulfillment of just being by themselves. So they always need somebody. I've known girls, guys, in the past that like were never single. Like they would be in a relationship and, you know, something would happen, and before you know it, like they would be in a different relationship. And like they did this like for years, and I was like, yo, how is this person never ever single? Like it never made any sense, right? And I'm like, you know, people do that. People literally jump from relationship to relationship, and they never take the time to be single to really focus on their relationship with themselves, right? Like, what about loving yourself, man? What about spending time with yourself? What about focusing on what your wants, your needs? I did a whole whole episode on the power of being alone, guys. Go watch that. I'll link it in the description below. But I talk about why it's necessary to be alone for a period in your life, guys, because you learn so much about yourself, right? What you want, what you don't want, what you like, what you dislike, right? Where your insecurities are, what you need to heal, what your traumas are. All of that is important to know. And you can only know that when you spend time with yourself. And spending time with yourself, that's how you cultivate self-love, guys. And also, if you don't have love for yourself, I'm talking genuine love, not love like narcissism, not the social media bullshit, right? Not that. Not like, oh, I posted a picture with like, you know, 5 filters and like Facetune and all this, and now, you know, people are sending me likes. Yeah, I love myself. I love who I... No, guys, I'm talking about loving your time alone, right? Loving being with yourself even when you're at rock bottom. You know, being compassionate for yourself, being gentle with yourself, learning to accept your weaknesses, learning to be okay with your flaws, and understanding, you know, your background, where you come from, your traumas, your insecurities, you know, being okay with all of that, but also learning to love the parts of you that other people don't love, or maybe you thought you didn't love, or maybe, you know, you grew up not loving or were taught not to love. Maybe it's your skin color. A lot of black people, man, shout out to them. I love my black folks out there. A lot of them have this, you know, this feeling inside, like, why am I, you know, born in this skin color? And because of that, you know, they don't love themselves truly, man. And it takes time to love yourself. Maybe you're handicapped, maybe you're disabled, maybe you can't walk, right? Maybe there's something wrong with you physically. Guys, you're gonna have to spend time to learn to love that before you expect anybody else to love that aspect of you or that part of you, guys. So remember that always. But you need to take time alone to do that. Next thing I want to say is, you know, continuing from spending that time alone, guys, figure out your insecurities, figure out your traumas, do the psychological work, do the shadow work, right? Integrate all archetypes within yourself. Integrate all aspects within yourself. Learn to be whole and learn to appreciate the wholeness that you are, right? There's aspects of yourself that you don't bring up to the surface, that you don't talk about easily, right? At least bring them up when you're by yourself, right? Face the fears, face your traumas, right? Whatever you know you've been through, whether it's abuse, domestic abuse, sexual abuse, you know, maybe you've been cheated on in the past, maybe you have trust issues, maybe you know your mother and father weren't there in the picture, maybe you have, you know, dad issues, mother issues, whatever, right? You got to heal them, because if you want a healthy relationship, that's why people are not in healthy relationships, because they haven't done the healing, guys. They haven't healed themselves properly. And so you need to heal yourself if you want to attract a healthy relationship. Now, don't get bogged down. Don't be like, oh man, that's a lot of work, this is going to take a long time. No. Enjoy the process, guys. It's a lifelong process, because you will attract the right person. You know, of course you will. When you've done a lot of the work, you will. And even in that relationship, right, things will come up and you have to look at them and you have to be like, yeah, man, I forgot to heal this one. Let me do that while I'm still in this relationship, but let me do it for the benefit of my partner, but also the benefit of myself, so I can continue to be a healthy partner for my partner, you know? Remember that, guys. So you want to spend time alone for that. Next thing I want to say, guys, is don't always focus on the absence of a relationship, because that's where the universe will keep delivering you exactly what you put out. What do I mean by this? So a lot of people, right, they're like, my partner's not here. Where's my partner? I can't find my partner. Where's this healthy relationship? There's no healthy relationships in this world. You know, the dating scene is fucked, right? Modern dating sucks. Women suck. Men suck. Guys, the list goes on. You've heard it all, right? Guys, if you're putting out this vibration all the time, you're never going to find that healthy person. You're never going to attract that healthy person, because let me tell you one thing. 100% of guys are not bad, and 100% of women are not bad. That's your perception. So it's all up to you what you're focused on. It's all up to you what you're putting out. If you're always putting out, you know, men ain't shit, you know, all women are promiscuous, all women are hoes, guys, that's what you're going to attract into your life. If you're always focused on the absence of healthy people or healthy partners or the absence of a relationship, you're always going to experience not having a relationship or not being in a relationship, because that's what your focus is on, guys. Remember that. So always pay attention to your mindset. Where are you fixated? Where are you focused? Right? Start talking about the things you want to talk about. Hey, you know, I'm single right now, but I'm loving my life. Right? Change your narrative. There are healthy people out there. There is such a thing as a virtuous man and a virtuous woman. They exist. Virtuous people exist. I only attract virtuous people in my life. Right? I only attract good people in my life. Start saying things that empower you, guys, because it's going to change your whole perception. It's going to change your whole focus. And that's what it's all about, because then you're going to start focusing on the right things. You're going to start attracting the right situations, places, people, events. And at the end of the day, that's what you want. You want to attract the right people. You want to attract the right partners, right? Or right partner, whatever. So guys, remember, don't focus on the absence of a relationship. Don't focus on it not coming. Don't focus, you know, on all the limitations. Get all of that out of your system. Get all of that out of your psyche, guys. And that may take some time. That may take some practice for you to shift your perception, guys. But you have to do it, or else you're not going to attract that healthy relationship. You know, I mean, that's really, you know, if some of this information is hitting you hard, guys, it's because I had to do all of this. I had to do all of this as well. I was single for many years, of course. Yeah, I dated around here and there. You know, I had some flings. But guys, you know, I realized that those things, you know, they weren't the one. Those relationships were not the one for me, you know, because I still had work to do. And so you may still have work to do. And also remember this, guys, you may attract people throughout your journey, right? That may come, but then they leave. You have to be okay with that. Not every single person that comes into your life is going to be the one, guys. Sometimes you need to go through these bad experiences for the character development. And once you develop your character, then finally you'll attract a good relationship. But don't just expect the first person to come into your life after watching this video or after watching any law of attraction video, oh my God, they're the one. Guys, it's not like that. It may take a few people. It may take a few years before the one comes in. And be okay, guys. Be patient. That's another thing I want to say. Be patient. Don't be needy. Don't be needy. Don't be impatient, guys, because that's another vibration you don't want to put out. You don't want to put out the vibration of being needy, because when you're needy, then one, you're more likely going to choose the wrong person, right? Because you're just ready to be in a relationship. You can't be alone. That means you still have some self-work to do. You're putting out this needy vibration to the universe, and the universe is only going to send you what you are right now, who you are right now. And if you're not content with who you are right now, if you're not where you want to be right now, if you still have work to do on yourself, you're going to attract somebody that has work to do on themselves. It's going to be a toxic relationship. Right, may not be super toxic if you're not, you know, at that level, but if you're super toxic yourself, best believe you're going to attract somebody super toxic as well. So the same thing, guys, I say is don't be needy. Take your time. Right? Just enjoy the process, guys. Learn to enjoy the flow of everything, because this is the thing. We're so quick to get to the finish line, but there is no finish line, because once you get that person, guys, being in a relationship is a whole different journey in itself. Right? That's a whole different journey, guys. And so that too also requires you to work. It's not like those self-work stops, guys. The self-work is a lifelong process, and you have to get used to that. You have to be okay with that, that, hey, the work is a lifelong process. The only thing I can do is just enjoy it, right? Take it day by day, enjoy it. Have fun. Whoever comes in, yeah, I'm gonna have a good time. I'm gonna, you know, enjoy myself. And if they're the one, awesome. If they're not, hey man, you know, I'm still doing the work. I'm still, you know, having fun. I'm still changing my focus, still changing my perceptions, still changing my thought patterns, you know, and be okay with that. Next thing I want to say, guys, is pray. Prayer is really powerful, man. I know in today's day and age, you know, prayer, it's like pray. No, but guys, pray for discernment. Pray for wisdom. Pray for that good, virtuous man or good, virtuous woman in your life, guys, whoever that may be. But pray, because God, he hears your prayers. The universe hears your words, your intentions, your feelings. All of that matters, guys. The universe will hear all of that. And so if you're praying for a good person, if you're praying to be on the right path, if you're praying, you know, because you want to have a family, you want to have kids, you want to have, you know, a healthy marriage, whatever it is you desire, you want that, right? And you're praying for it, guys, best believe God will deliver. Of course God will deliver, because he sees your desire, and your desire is pure. It's a pure desire to want a healthy relationship. It's a pure desire to be in a healthy marriage. Of course it is, right? You want to raise healthy kids. You want to, you know, you want to improve society for generations to come. Of course, that's a really pure desire, guys. God will definitely fulfill that, but you must pray. Right? You must start praying. Start praying for that. Start praying for your own, you know, healing. Start praying for your own coming to terms with yourself. But also pray that you're able to, you know, improve who you are as well. Expand your soul as well. Do the work you need to do as well. Pray for all that. Pray for strength. Pray for courage. God will hear your prayers, guys. And also, when you pray, you're also influencing your subconscious. I'm going to make a true video on the science of prayer and how prayer influences your subconscious, guys. But when you're praying, right, you're holding steadfast to that vision of you being in that relationship. How does it feel? It feels so good, right? How does it feel to be in that relationship? It feels exciting. It feels loving. It feels joyful. It feels empowering. It feels like freedom. It feels like flowing, like water flowing downhill. It feels good. Right? It feels happy. It feels exciting. It feels like a thrill. It feels thriving. It feels like blossoming. Guys, you have to put yourself in that vibration. And that's what prayer does. But also put yourself in that vibration. Whenever you have some time, right? Sit down, maybe at the park, on a bench, maybe at the beach, wherever you are. Go out in nature, right? Just maybe close your eyes, or maybe you can do it with your eyes open, right? But just feel yourself. How does it feel to be in that relationship? I used to do it all the time, guys. I used to do it all the time back in the day. I used to just, you know, sit at the park bench, look out at the water, and just, you know, I would get a smile on my face because I was picturing myself being in that relationship, right? Like, you're going on trips together. How does that feel, right? It feels fun. It feels exciting. It feels refreshing. It feels new. It feels like freedom. It feels like comfort. It feels like security, right? It feels good. Or, you know, you can picture yourself holding hands, walking in the park. You can picture yourself, you know, going to concerts together, you know, going on dates together. You can picture yourself living together. There's so much you can do, but get in that mode of vibration, right? Get in that feeling state, because that's going to attract things faster to you, guys, because that's where your vibration is. You know how I said earlier, don't be needy. Don't don't feel the absence of it. Same thing, guys. When you're picturing yourself, when you're visualizing, when you're in that mode of being, in that mode of vibration, right? You're sending out to the universe the signal that I already have what I want. Spiritually, it's already done. Non-physically, it's already manifested, right? I'm just enjoying it. I'm just being thankful for it. That's another thing, guys. Start being thankful for the relationship because it's coming. It's on its way. So start being thankful in advance, right? It will speed up that process too, you guys. But then again, don't speed it up because you need. Don't be needy. Don't be needy, guys. You're doing it because it's all about having fun. It's about, you know, going with the flow. It's about enjoying the process, guys, the culmination process. You have to do that. So remember that, guys. Last thing I want to say is, guys, practice celibacy. I know this is a little bit out of the blue, but the reason I say this, guys, when you have a period in your life where you're celibate, you know, you're chaste, you're practicing chastity, semen retention, whatever, guys, NoFap. I'm a big proponent of that. You guys can check out some videos on my YouTube channel. You're doing that for God, right? You're doing it because you realize, hey, man, I want to be pure for my partner, right? I want to be pure for, you know, the person that's coming into my life. Of course. Would you want a partner who's hooking up all the time and then comes in your life and you're like, you know, guy number 40 or girl number 40? Do you want to be that person? Or guy number 100 or girl number 100 that, you know, they get with? No, you don't want to be like that, guy. So take some time to practice some celibacy. It'll build up your connection with God. It'll build up self-respect for you, yourself, right? Build up the connection with yourself. You'll learn how to be without wanting sex all the time, right? But then also when you meet the opposite gender, the first thing you don't focus on is sex, because a lot of relationships are together because of sex, right? That's a big thing, guys. And so when you can be celibate for a while, sex goes on the back burner, and then you start actually looking at people for who they really are. Because, guys, of course, I know sex means a great deal to y'all, and you know you guys want good sex. Of course, I get it. But guys, that shouldn't be the foundation of your relationship. Sex should not be the foundation of your relationship. If anything, it should be based on character. It should be based on morals. It should be based on virtues. And then, yeah, bring in sex eventually, you know, whatever, guys, you know. But that's why I say it takes some time to be celibate so you can shift your mindset, shift your paradigms, guys. And then when you meet the person, it's not like, oh, let's hook up ASAP, you know. It's more about, you know, who are you? How are you? Right? What do you believe? What are your morals? Right? What are your virtues? All these things, guys, that's what it's all about. And so I've given you a small blueprint in this video, guys, of how you can manifest a healthy relationship. Take all of this advice to heart, you know, because it has worked for me over the years, you know. And for me, when I attracted my healthy relationship, I was literally in a period of celibacy. But I had also been doing everything else I've listed in this video. I had been doing the self-work. I had been doing the self-improvement. Right, I had gone through the many experiences of small affairs and flings and dating and stuff like that. And at that time in my life, I wasn't looking for anybody. And then, bam, that's when that person came. And that's usually when they come. When you're not looking, guys, that's when they come. That's when they come, literally. So like I said, don't be needy. Don't always focus on the absence. Get busy with your life. Get busy with traveling. Get busy with your goals, your purpose, right? Whatever you want to do. And eventually that person will come. But in the meantime, enjoy your life, enjoy the process. And then yes, write down the characteristics, guys, so you know subconsciously what you're looking for. And also, like I said, the first person that comes in your life may not be the one, guys. It may take a few people, but you know, just enjoy the experience. But that's the message for today. Please like, please subscribe to my channel and share this message with anybody that you feel like could use this information. It's your boy, Sabby. Thank you once again for tuning into today's episode. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Peace.